Welcome to the automation zone. In this tutorial, we'll be looking at the lambda expressions. So what is a lambda expression? A lambda expression can be used to replace a one line function and it does not have any name. Okay, so to explain this, let's have a function called as add. It accepts two parameters a and b, and this function is a one line function which prints the sum of a and b. Okay, let me go ahead and call my function with the values 1 and 2. So 1 is assigned to a and 2 is assigned to b, and print a plus b will give you the output as 3. Okay, this is for those who do not know how a function is created. So now I can replace this one line function by a lambda expression. So use the keyword lambda. So a function has a keyword def, a lambda has a keyword lambda. After def, we give the function name. Now lambda expressions being nameless, it will not have any name. Following that, just as a function, we give our parameters. Our parameters, if many, just as a function, we separated it by a comma. Okay, the rules will remain the same. Following that, we give a colon. And then we give the one line code. In this case, it is print a plus b. So lambda is going to create a function called as print a plus b, which is nameless, having the parameters a and b. The parameters are optional. You may not give them as well, or you can give them. Okay, let me run this. So you see, we do not get any output. Why is that? See, we have created a lambda expression, but we have not called it. Here we have created a function, but we have called it as well. But how do we call it? You see, a function will have a name, hence we can call the function by using the function's name. A lambda function being nameless, we do not have any name to call it. So what we do is, we assign it to a variable or to an object. So what we'll do here in this case, we'll make a variable called as add, and we'll assign our lambda expression to this function add. And now we can simply call a variable add just as a function, giving it two values 1 and 2, and then running it, we get the output as 3. Now, is it necessary for you to always, you know, assign the lambda expression to a variable and then call it? Yes, but in certain cases, no. Those cases are going to be maps, filters, and some other situations, which we'll be talking more in the next tutorial. Okay, because these are going to be some advanced topics on filters. Sorry, on list. So this was a very basic tutorial on what a lambda expression is and how to use it and why we use it. Another good thing to note is that a lambda expressions does compress a code. Okay, it'll compress your function to a single line, yes, but on the flip side, it makes it less readable. Okay, if you have any questions with regarding to lambda expressions, do comment below, I'll help you. If you need any other tutorials, you can comment that as well, I'll create them for you. If you like my tutorials, do subscribe. Thank you.